There is no minimum age for the appreciation of Shakespeare. Here is Rafe Esquith, a fifth-grade teacher at Hobart Elementary School in Los Angeles.
Our class is very well known for putting on unabridged productions of Shakespeare every year, even though my students come from a 92% poverty background and no one speaks English as a first language. All of the students that I work with come from another country, and people ask me all the time, why in the world would you throw Shakespeare at them? And the answer is very simple. If you think about the themes of Shakespeare, here we are in the inner city of Los Angeles, and we just finished doing both parts of Henry IV, plays about violence, honor, and honor in a dishonorable world. And if you don't think the kids growing up in this part of the country have dealt with those issues in their own way, on their own streets, you are very much mistaken. I do Shakespeare because the kids relate to him immediately. He writes about the big issues. He writes about violence or love or jealousy. I think once people understand what he's all about, it's really not a big stretch for these kids to get into his world. 20 years here and all the plays we've done are proof of it. I think Shakespeare was a genius, and I think geniuses do things that the rest of us can't understand. I don't know how Mozart wrote his music. I don't know how great athletes move in ways that I cannot dream of moving. I just know that for whatever reason, Shakespeare connects with the whole world in ways that no other writer I can ever think of has done. The other day, my class for the first time watched Act 5, Scene 2 of Hamlet. These were 10-year-olds, and they got to the scene when Gertrude was about to drink from the poison cup. The kids knew this scene was coming. They'd read it. And yet when they saw it on film, they were on the edge of their chairs begging her not to drink. And I laughed at them later and I said, you guys were so emotional. It's not like you didn't know it was coming. And they said, I know, but it's just so good. It's like nothing we've ever seen before. And I said, you're starting to understand Shakespeare.
Once again, George T. Wright.
His characters are wonderful characters, and the plots are very attractive plots. They're plots that have a resonance all over the world, really. And the proof of this, I suppose, is that his plays have been produced in countries all over the world, and often by companies that wanted to make some sort of parallel between the social system that they were laboring under and the ones that are set up in Shakespeare's plays. He deals so often with questions of justice and power, and his plots involve people murdering each other and involved in the most intense kinds of relations with each other, love, hate, all sorts of things. But you can't help getting drawn into the problems of these characters because they have counterparts in everyday life today. He makes an appeal that transcends borders. There's no limit really to the way in which he does appeal. His popularity is certainly not due to schools requiring that people read him, or governments requiring that the plays be produced. The plays get produced because people want to see them, directors want to direct them, filmmakers want to film them.
Shakespeare's popularity is not limited to English-speaking countries. He is the most widely performed dramatist in the world. Here is Chu Swan from the Central Dramatic Theater of Vietnam performing the part of Titania from A Midsummer Night's Dream, done in a language Shakespeare never knew existed.
Có thể cho đến sau ngày cưới của Theseus.
Ồ.
Nếu chàng muốn nhảy một cách lặng lẽ trong những cuộc vui của bọn ta, hoặc xem những trò chơi của bọn ta dưới ánh trăng thì hãy theo ta. Bằng không hãy tránh xa ta, và ta cũng sẽ tránh xa những nơi chàng tới.
Ôi Titania, hãy trao đứa bé cho ta, ta sẽ theo nàng.
Không, dù có đổi cả vương quốc, ta...